Can you just give a really, really brief summary of the organization that you currently represent, just so that people at home kind of know?
Sure. So I work for the Electronic Frontier Foundation, which is a 25-year-old organization in the United States that defends digital rights online through litigation, advocacy, and technology.
What are your main concerns with Facebook and the activity of journalists, to summarize it again?
Sure. I mean, I think that there are a lot of reasons to be concerned, but my focus has been on the way that Facebook controls our speech. I think that its policies around certain aspects, including nudity, including identity, have shifted the way that we think about these things and can possibly in the future shift the way that our culture treats different types of speech or different types of expression.
And would you say at any point that Facebook has been unconstitutional in the type of speech they're banning?
Not exactly, in the sense that in the United States, the law actually allows public platforms like Facebook to regulate speech as they like. Facebook has the right to regulate you, and they also, in return, are not liable for most things that people post. However, I do think that Facebook's policies are, let's say, out of sync with the First Amendment in the US.
And you mentioned briefly in there a small anecdote about a family member who'd become increasingly right-wing, and you mentioned that something through the filter, so could you explain?
Yeah, so I have a family member, a distant family member, who I don't see very often, and she has been for years, you know, kind of using Facebook to post her political views. In the beginning it wasn't so bad, but her views became increasingly noxious, increasingly right-wing, and at some point I felt that I had to ban her. And so I think that the reason that this happens with people like her, who are not particularly savvy or sophisticated news consumers, is that they're kind of looped into what has been called the filter bubble, certainly not my phrase, but they're kind of looped into this, and it becomes this self-fulfilling prophecy. And so I think that, you know, we have to, on the one hand, we have to, you know, look at how Facebook's doing this, but on the other hand, we also have to make people become better news consumers and educate them.
And is there any way do you think to kind of scale up that education on a more mass level?
That's a really good question and a little bit outside of my wheelhouse, but I think it's something that we certainly have to try, and it starts with public schools.